and it's hard for me to describe it. All that stuff they say is evidence. You look through it, and there is no evidence against anybody, me or Paul. There wasn't any time. And just too much made-up stuff, that's all I can say. It's and it's too bad that sometimes the system works that way on feelings instead of facts, you know. So, but I am relieved, and I worry about my son, of course.
Mr. Flores, any comments for the family, the victim's family?
Yeah, I feel bad for him because they didn't get no answers about what happened to their daughter. And we don't know what happened to their daughter. So, and I, like I said, I feel sorry for them.
What was your reaction when you learned your son was found guilty?
I don't know. I was just holding on, that's all.
Are you in a state of shock?
A little bit.
Mr. Nisik, this is a big case for you. Is this the biggest case you've won or taken on?
No, but it's the one I've been most invested in on a personal level. Because as you might remember, what I said at the very beginning in this case, this man is not just not guilty, he's absolutely innocent. And today's verdict proved that. So you can quibble with me on the words there, but he never should have been charged. And I'm very pleased with the outcome. Love our system of justice. Jury is what it is. Jury has absolute power to say whatever they want to say. But in this particular case, they said not guilty, and I think that's the right verdict.